Hey, what's up, everyone? All right, so I'm at a different gym today. We're in, I think it's Norwalk or somewhere. It's like somewhere in LA. I'm not exactly sure, but there's a lot of soccer players around and sports groups here, so. But there's a gym next door just here called Fit Nation. So I'm gonna get a workout here. It's really hot inside. It's not the biggest gym, but we'll see what they've got. And I'm just waiting for my coach. He's coming now. Eric, he's gonna show us a good workout, a chest pump and a deltoid workout, I think, today. So it's, what time is it anyway? It's a little bit late. It's like 8:30. It's a bit later than usual, but that's all right. This gym's open, I think, even later. Thank God I don't have to wear a mask inside, because there are a few gyms I've been to where you're required to wear a mask, and I honestly can't show you with a mask over my face when I'm trying to breathe. It just suffocates me. So, well, I don't. I just pull it down. But I got in trouble for that as well. So it should be a good little workout. Chest and deltoids. I'm 5 weeks out from the show. From this competition. It seems like we've like fast forwarded it. I've got 4.5 weeks before the show. So. My chest is a little bit sore from last week, so I'm just going to have to work around that. It's not feeling too good at the moment, but whatever, is what it is. Hopefully some stretching and stuff, and then the rest of the week, just trying to keep on top of my recovery and stuff so I can stay optimal for my other workouts. My current weight is 239, 240. It's around there, so I managed to put on 10 pounds in the last 5 weeks, which isn't too bad considering I've only had like 10 weeks notice for this competition or whatever it was. I'm not sure how much time I gave myself for this show. So I've been able to put on a bit of weight, but I've kind of plateaued. It's hard to keep adding on pounds while you're dieting as well. So I'm trying to work around it, but anyway, we'll head in and we'll get all signed up at the start.
Sit Council and Traders. I am going to give you my commentary and a breakdown of my chest and deltoid pump workout with Eric the other day. Need to have a lot of carbs to stay full. If I don't eat an hour before, and then if I'm not like constantly putting carbs through my body, I go flat. So that drink that you see me sipping on, it's full of carbs. So I've got that with me always, with BCAAs as well. First exercise, just warming up the deltoids with side lateral raises. Just lightweight, get the blood in there, and rotate some rotator exercises to help warm up the shoulder joint. And it's just helps with injury prevention and getting the muscles primed for the workout. So they're the two variations of the shoulder warm-ups. I think it's important, especially for, you can do them in other workouts too, your chest or your back. It's always good to warm up your rotators, your shoulders, because they cop a beating. So moving up to some heavier dumbbells for a working set. And these, I think we're doing about, usually I'll do like 3 to 4 sets, 12 to 15 reps to begin with. Drink more carbs. And you'll see as the workout progresses, you'll see the pump gets more intense with the carbs and the weights. So.
Whoa, come on. 13.
Skin splitting pumps. Oh, you see, can't support to see. So this gym, I mean, it was cool. It was like a lot of old school equipment. The yellow equipment was really cool. This shoulder machine, well, the seat was busted on it, so I just had to roll up a yoga mat and use that. And despite it's only 45 pounds, this machine felt heavy. It was actually hard. It's an individual, so you... It's each arm is individual, and it's a different machine. I haven't seen these kind of, I haven't used these kind of shoulder machine before. It kind of goes up in an arc, you know, over your head, which is good for your anterior deltoid muscles. Yeah.
Want something to drink, right?
Oh yeah, that water. Can you go? Yeah, sweet, thanks. Do you want? Oh, if you want them. So. So this next exercise, the rear pec deck flies for your rear deltoids. Particularly a great exercise for just isolating your rear delts. You can see my coach is helping me focus on them. I think this is a crucial exercise to build a complete shoulder. If you want a full, you know, you'll see some guys and they've got great middle, they've done a lot of side laterals and they've got the front deltoids going and everything, but they haven't got a rear deltoid popping out the back. Like, that's all kind of like they forgot to train the back of their shoulders or something, like just because they can't see it or they can't activate it, or maybe. But this is the trick to doing rear deltoids is you've really got to focus on that muscle. You know, it's not a huge muscle, but you can see it. It's pretty clear there. You have to do these isolation exercises to really target it. And in this particular workout, I did supersetting two different exercises to hit the same muscle. So doing these rear flies, and then like a rear deltoid. I don't know what you thought, that machine where you pull it back, like a row. It's like a high rear delt row, so it's like a fly in a row, and this combo is crazy pumps for your rear delts. It's like combining a chest press, like a bench press, and a dumbbell fly together. You know, or a pec deck fly, you get an insane pump. But you know, that's what you got to do if you want to have, you know, a decent physique. So yeah. So we're just talking about the different angles and stuff, you know, the different grips on the machine. Sometimes you can do a reverse hand grip, but I think the most common way is just to having palms facing inwards and just squeezing it back that way. It's the most effective. We did like three or four sets, you know, 10 to 15 reps. With as much weight as you can handle before the form gets too sloppy. Rack. Uh-huh. Damn, I haven't really seen the mod back workout, like working it from behind. It's pretty decent. It shows off the physique quite well. So this is the outside section of the gym. So it's pretty cool. It's like I said, it's surrounded by these supplements.
What's this area? Deltoid raise.
That's a good one.
Okay, we can do that one after. What else is there?
Let's get a barbell. We'll do the upright row.
What's it?
This is a soccer field.
Oh no, I want to
bring
oh, you there? Are you there? We need to recruit four more players. Because that looks so much fun, like playing soccer in those little courts. I'll probably just chill in the goals because I don't like what I got. I'll start in the goals. But no, it looks cool, eh? Looks fun. I haven't played soccer for so long.
How long did you play soccer?
I played 8 years, like high school. Yeah, all, like half of high school and primary school. Yeah, fair while. But no. So what are we doing now? We got front raises, barbell front raises, with some motivation. Franco Colombo ripping some deads right in front of me. It's good motivation, but yeah, not crazy weights. I'm not like obviously reefing up as much that many pounds on the barbell. But you don't need to, you know, because you're just isolating your front deltoid. You just want to squeeze it and get a good pause at the top if possible. And I'm supersetting them with calf raises, just to throw in the mix there. You know, the calves always need attention, so you got to give it to them when you can. So I just done the, I think it was like a 3 or 4 set, superset for this workout. I like doing supersets together. I think it's a great way to keep your workouts flowing fast, and you're not at the gym too long. If you can superset, you know, different muscle groups, it's a great idea. That way you can train more in a short amount of time. And personally, I don't like staying in the gym for long periods of time. You know, I try and keep my workouts under an hour 20, an hour max usually. That way I don't go catabolic. You don't want to go catabolic, bruh. Lose all your gains. So that's why it's good to have the carbs on hand. That way it helps prevent and slow down the muscle breakdown and build it up. So, nothing crazy on those front
legs. Come on. Six. Let's fight. Let's go. That's it. Come on. 10. Come on. That's easy. Easy. 11, come on,
11,
15, let's go, 12, come on,
13, 2 more. I do like 3 sets, I think it's 3 sets here, about 15 reps, we tried to get 15 reps on. And the next exercise was, so this is it's a machine, a side lateral machine for your deltoids, but I did a variation of it, where instead of doing 2 at once facing that machine, you sit on the side and you do 1 arm at a time, and it's just another way to isolate each arm individually. So it's a good way to get a very focused pump on each deltoid. And we superset that with the standing calf raises this time. And here's Eric, he's showing me to do, he's got some good calves, he does a lot of hiking, I guess. It's a good variation on the standing calf raise, where you do 2 different movements. So it's like you go half up and then you spring it up a little bit further on your tiptoes. You'll see there's 2 movements, bang, ready. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2. So that way, you get a good squeeze at the top.
Come on, couple more.
Yeah.
Couple more. Come on. Couple more. Good.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
It's good having a coach to train with. I'm not gonna lie. It's been a long time since I've had any good training partners like this. Especially with Eric, he's a very experienced coach, and it's good to have someone, you know, watch over you and kind of help just push you that extra mile, because, you know, most of the time we give up before we know we can, our minds give up before our bodies do, and we don't want to do any more. So when you have someone to push you, you're going to get a lot more out of your workout. Especially when you have someone to push you who knows exactly what they're doing, and they're trained professionals at what they do, it makes a huge difference. You know, this workout was very fast paced. I didn't really hardly have any much time to rest. You know, we got in there, we got it done. I wasn't mucking around. I haven't got any time to muck around at this point. You know, I'm 4 weeks out. So every single workout counts, every single rep counts, every set, every exercise. You have to make every single thing count, you know, every meal, all the naps, everything. Everything is now like critical for the final day. So there's no bull. there's no time to waste. How many? I think I did 4 sets of these or something. So after that, that's now we're at 17:30. We're doing, these are like rear cable flies with, for the rear, another exercise for the rear deltoid. And not only does it target just the rear deltoid, it also hit, your rhombus, your traps a little bit, it'll target a lot of areas in your back too. So, decided to do another rear deltoid exercise. I think it really does make a huge difference when you can, when you have a really developed, it completes the physique, not only from the front and the side, but you have to have the back looking insane too. So try chucking these in your shoulder workout next time you're at the gym. Just bend over and one arm at a time. And it's just like, it's the opposite of a chest fly. It's of a pec fly. It's a reverse rear deltoid fly. Three sets, and then we did, two, yeah. Cause it's closing out, coming up to the end of the workout. So two there, 15 reps, I think we were trying to get. And then we moved on and did the, I don't think I could do this one as well because my chest was bothering me. I think we went to do a rear delt fly dumbbell with a bench, but I don't think I did this one. I think we just skipped past it. Yeah. Side deltoid with side lateral raises with a cable, and just doing behind the back raises with some help from Eric. We did like two sets again for as many reps. I think it was like 12, 15. Always many more reps with the delts. The shoulder gets used in a lot of different workouts, back and chest, it's all assisted, so it's good to get extra reps in when you can. Bit of a commotion,
yeah. Chopper as well.
Sounds like chopper, yeah. Cops, who knows this time. And then we did some shrugs, dumbbell shrugs to finish the shoulder part of the workout. Nothing too crazy, I haven't done these intense workouts for a while, and I haven't really done any deadlifts and traps exercises for a minute, so the last time I did them I was sore for a week. I had to take a while to recover from the last time, so I'm not doing crazy poundages on the traps. Doesn't matter, I've already got them, so whatever. What the hell's going on outside? They're after us again. And then moved on to a little chest pump. So we're doing some machine bench presses. Close grip, wide grip. Just to change it up a little bit. And yeah, it's a good... These hurt. I had like a tight chest from earlier, so I was in pain for these ones. They didn't feel nice. And then finishing again, this is just it was more of deltoid focused workout with a little chest pump at the end. So I just used some not crazy poundages. I think I was just marking around with like 45s for some incline presses for reps of like 15, two or three sets I think we did. And then after that, move on to a little bit of posing, I believe. What are we at? We're at 24:51. And now it's time for some poses, just to check up on the physique, a little bit of a progress, a little bit of a catch up. There's five poses that I've got to nail for the show. front double bicep, a side chest, a rear double bicep. That's the better side chest. A rear double bicep, abdominal thighs, and a favorite classic pose. So you gotta find out, you know, for me, I'm just determining which sides are the best sides for me to showcase my strengths, hide my weaknesses, which is obviously my quad that I tore in the cliff accident. My left bicep, the one where I've got my tattoo, that was the one that I tore, even though it's made a full recovery. And the size and the shape is back. It's still, you know, you still got to determine which bicep's got the better peak. My right one has the better peak. So now I'm looking at the quads, and we do abdominal thigh. So obviously I'm going to put my best foot, my best leg forward, which is my left quad, and the right one sits behind. My right quad, I've been able to actually put on a fair bit of mass. I was actually going to measure it. Even though I haven't got the definition in it and all the size back, it's getting closer. So yeah. So now we're just working on some angles on a classic physique pose, on the favorite classic pose. I think my elbow is giving me some trouble for some reason. I can't remember. I think I had some some cramps or something in my forearm. And then I wasn't satisfied, so I went and did some more bench presses on the Smith machine. A Smith machine bench press, kind of like just to help stretch out the chest. Again, not doing heavy weights, but this is just a pump workout for the chest. What are we at now? 20. So I did I think we jacked it up to three sets there with about 10 reps. Moving on to the cable flies. It's a good exercise for pumping it up and getting all the blood into your chest. You know, I think this is one of the best finishes for the chest workout. And then outside again.
That's hurt.
28:08. Finishing on a chest press machine, which is cross between a bench press and a fly. Your arms go down by your sides and they kind of arc up in towards the middle. So I think my chest and shoulders are absolutely fried by this point. Nevertheless, it was a really good workout, and this kind of training is definitely these are the kind of workouts that you're gonna notice some significant results and progress, you know, in the days to follow. So there's always one more exercise. I think it was just a finishing thing, like some presses, some bodyweight presses, more blood. See, these are the sort of things that I would have stopped after. I would have stopped two exercises ago, two or three. I would have been like, okay, I'm done. But that's why it's good having a coach. You can have someone to push you the extra mile. All right, that's it. So thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and yeah, peace out, Cub Scout.
So that concludes today's chest and deltoid pump workout. This is my coach Eric Deloro from he's from Canada. 2015 we won the Mr. Universe together, so he prepped me for those shows in that year. It was probably my best year. It was my best year for competing and shape and sort everything. So we teamed up again this year to get me back into, you know, as best shape as I possibly can with such a minimal time frame. I think we joined hands about 9 weeks out or 10 weeks out, which is not ideal, but you know, screw it. We don't have time to make any decisions on any other show. So yeah, so that was a good workout.
Yeah, so it's definitely going to be a challenge this time due to the injuries that you had, you know, in the past with the bicep and then the leg. But you know, if we're gonna do it, we might as well do it now and get in the mix and get back to our strengths. You know, when we prepared for the universe in 2015, of course we didn't have those challenges. But I believe with your genetic makeup that, you know, within the time frame, with it, which is a short amount of period of time, I believe that we'll really excel.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
you know, I think in the long term, it's going to be even more beneficial. It's you know, we're going to peak, you know, in 2021.
Yeah,
you know, we just want to get our feet wet, get in there.
This is the first
jump in the show.
Decent training I've done all year. It's the first decent training I've done in the last 2 years since my injuries. You know, and there's probably not a specific split where I'm training my legs twice a week, almost four, almost like twice a week, two times a day sometimes. So we really have customized the plan, and now it's just a matter of me getting in the meals and the water and following the plan to try to execute. So what weight do I have to be on the stage?
230.
So I've got to be, so if I'm 240 now, we can maybe put on a few more, if that, try and put on 5-8 pounds, it would be great. It's very hard, but and then we've got to dial it down to 230. So
what's great with Callum is he stays lean, so you know, whatever we do gain, it's going to be lean
good,
muscle
good gains.
And then obviously we just pull out the water and we'll be ready,
go from there. Exactly. Good stuff, guys. I'll see you soon on the next workout, and whatever that is, whenever that is. Peace. All right, man, I'm chasing, he's cooked. He's absolutely